and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a makeup tutorial for you with a springtime theme, and I wanted to wear a pink shirt and I didn't have a pink shirt, so that's my excuse for wearing a scarf as a shirt. Anyway, back onto the makeup. We're gonna start with a white eye primer and then we're gonna move on to colors. I'm going to use the BH Cosmetics Take Me Back to Brazil palette every time. I feel like I pronounce it so weird and I don't know why. Anyway, it contains a lot of bright colors but also a lot of pastels, and today I want to go for the pastels, which is always a bit tricky because it might just turn weird, muddy shades of white. And I'm starting off with a decidedly not very pastel color. Yeah, I just decided to go for a turquoise that turned out to be approximately 53,000 million times as opaque and deep as I thought it would be. Which is technically a good thing, but like kind of unexpected, I guess. Anyway, we're just gonna blend it out, and I know as much as you do about... Actually, you know more than I do at this point about how this look is going to turn out. Because you've already seen the thumbnail. I have no idea what this is going to be, but I'm going to try to make this pastel. Next up, we're gonna go for pink, and this one is actually a pastel shade. I mean, it's already pastel in the pan, so I knew it wouldn't turn out darker than I wanted it to. But anyway, this look is, by the way, vaguely inspired by springtime flowers. I know absolutely nothing about flowers, so I have no idea what all the different types of flowers that bloom in spring are called. But nevertheless, you know, think of stuff like blossom and like cute blue flowers, cute other pink flowers, yellow flowers, purple flowers, all sorts of flowers that probably have names that I do not know. You know, this is one thing I love about springtime, just seeing all those different types of flowers in, like, you know, just in parks and in people's front yards, and it just looks so fun, you know, like, I love the colors of seasons, I guess. You know, and pastel shades just really make me think of all the flowers in springtime. Just as with autumn, I always love to go for, like, vampy, dark, warm colors, inspired by autumn shades. But yeah, even though autumn is in fact my favorite season, I do actually think every season is just, I don't know, fun. I love the differences between seasons. Like, I'm totally not the type, just doing an eyebrow highlight by the way, but I'm totally not the type who's like, I hate winter or I hate summer. No, I just love both equally. They each have their own fun parts. What I do always have is like, near the end of a season, I'm already completely ready for the next season. Like, every season just lasts like, I don't know, 3 weeks too long for me, I guess. But yeah, I like change, I like diversity in stuff in life. So yeah. Now moving on to yellow, and I'm just using the same brush. You could totally use a like flat brush for your eyelid part, but I was already using this brush, and this way I only have to wash one brush afterwards, which is nice. So yeah, we're just gonna go for it. Also, by the way, the only rhyme or reason I have for the color placement is just that I wanted this to be the darkest, so I used the what I thought and was correct. Sorry, gotta go smack a lamp. For regular viewers, yes, that's still the same old lamp with the F's up on and off switch. Anyway, what I was trying to say, this, well, I wanted to be the darkest, so I put a darker shade there, and then I wanted the inner corner to be the palest, and yellow is probably going to be the palest look in this. The palest color in this. So that's my reason for that placement. But you could totally do a completely different placement or use completely different pastel shades overall. Now for the middle of the eyelid, I'm going to use a neon green shade, which is actually neon green. And I'm very happy about that because it gave me an idea for a sort of poison-ish eye look. I don't know, there's always with this, with, like with this type of palette with like a lot of colors, there is usually one or two colors in there that are like, okay, is there even anything there at all? And you never know which one it is until you grab it and realize it is absolutely invisible. But thus far, all these actually perform pretty nicely, so that's good. Now, in the exact outer corner, I want some peachy sort of orange. Not necessarily because I was missing something, although I do love how it looks. But mostly because it looked so pretty in the pan, so I decided I wanted it on my eyelid right now. And because I feel like the random color placement thing is kind of fun. I'm also doing the same with a lilac shade, but a smaller brush in the inner corner crease here, because it looks fun, but if I were to do this with a big brush, then it would just be like, boom, purple. Which I don't want, so yeah, tinier brush is a little bit safer. I just randomly decided to actually prime my bottom eyelid as well and do that first before I do my face. I really hope I'm going to remember and not mess it up with my concealer later on, but we'll see. And I'm gonna start off in the bottom outer corner with the lilac shade, which is going to be the darkest color down there. Oh, and do make sure, by the way, that everything is nice and mixed. I was gonna say like an impressionistic flower garden, but with impressionism is more like dotty and not blended. So more like a really blurry camera photo of like a flower garden or something. Whatever you call it, just blend it well. That's really all I'm trying to explain here. Next step is a little bit risky because it might look like eye irritation. I'm going to use the orange shade that also used up here. And I'm going to apply it thickly enough that you can really tell that it's supposed to be... It's really hard to pull your eye like this and then talk. Anyway, you can really tell that it's supposed to be there and not just an irritated part of my eyelid. Okay, now I'm just going to really wipe down the brush and grab a lot of a sort of green tinted highlight. Also in the same palette. And use it as a highlight. I know, surprising. Next up, a very bad idea. Remember that eye primer that I was complaining about in one of my last videos? That was not performing well in my opinion because it was too greasy and didn't stick well enough to actually show off all its pigment. Well, I've used the same eye primer today and now I'm going to try and use it as an eyeliner. Okay, so this worked a lot better than I anticipated actually. But I don't think it's actually quite white enough yet, so I am going to toss a white eyeshadow on top of it to make it brighter. Next up in the category of weird ideas and like the torture of an innocent eye primer, I'm going to stuff it on a spoolie, run it through my eyelashes and then push eyeshadow on top of it to get a colored eyeliner. I hope. Alternatively, you could totally just use a colored eyeliner, mascara if you have one. I was talking about colored mascara. Point is, or you could use body paint, but I wanted to use only normal makeup so that if you want, for whatever weird reason, you can actually copy this as well if you don't have special effects makeup. So yeah, beauty makeup only. Okay, now I'm just pushing green eyeshadow into it. Hopefully it's going to turn green. Also, by the way, I had this period in time where I found it a good idea to use coconut oil as an eyelash treatment. My eyelashes felt less greasy than they do at this moment. Just so you know. Then on the bottom we got to do the turquoise, and also I'm totally, completely surprised that my eyelashes are actually taking on the color that I'm putting on them. Like, I totally did not expect this to work. But it does. Then just really quick some fluttery falsies along with it. This is the before. And here is the after. Yeah, I also, by the way, very obviously did my foundation, concealer, powder and eyebrows. Just because everyone does them their own way and I feel like this tutorial is getting long enough without showing you the redundant stuff, I guess. So yeah, we can immediately move back to the eyes with an eye pencil. And now we can move on to the face again with the actual colored stuff, the more interesting things, I guess. This is a very bright pink blush, which I'm applying with a stippling brush, and I'm applying like 3 molecules at a time so it doesn't get too intense. Also, seriously, do you ever finish a brush? Blush with an L, not with an R. Do you ever finish a blush? Because I don't ever finish a blush. Ever. Probably because of the whole 3 molecules method. But yeah, this is like seriously an ancient Essence Silky Touch blush. I don't even know if they still sell these actually, but you know, it still works. It's still pretty. It's probably expired. Let's ignore that fact. Oh, and by the way, like before filming, I actually cleaned my vintage mirror with a microfiber, like the cleaning thingy. I can't English today. Anyway, I cleaned it and now it's like clearer than life again because it was made in like a vintage way with like silver and it's like... I can see blemishes on my face of which I didn't even know I had them. I'm not sure if I'm happy with this. Like, seriously, the thing to take away from this really is... maybe it's a good idea to not clean your vintage mirrors too well. Just for your own ego. Anyway, that aside, I'm going to move on to setting spray. And while the setting spray is still damp, I'm going to immediately go on with a slightly green tinted highlight. So it's going to be nice and intense. Now lastly, the lips. I'm going to start off with a almost empty, pretty much dried out liquid lipstick in a soft pink shade. I should really buy full sizes of things so I can actually use them properly. Anyway, then I'm going to top it with a lip gloss, both because I want it to be glossy, but also to hopefully hide the dried outness of the liquid lipstick. Okay, I gotta say I'm amazed at how much I still managed to squeeze out of that. But yeah, lip gloss on top and then we're done. And here we have the final result. Seriously, I'm pretty sure that the eyeshadow is getting into my contact lens because it's currently hating me. But anyway, I like how this look turned out. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you don't want to miss any of my future videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. One little tiny bit of interesting information. If you want to know exactly what I used on my face today, you can always find it below the video in the description in a handy little list. And other than that, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!